again. Phil Caldwell, CEO of CeresPower, the fuel cell technology specialist, is with us here at Proactive. First of all, Phil, Happy New Year to you. Tell us first about this joint development agreement with another OEM.
Yeah, it's a significant milestone for the company because we set ourselves a target of 5 significant OEMs within 2 years, and this is number 5. What's very pleasing about it is it's another high quality global OEM. It's the first one that's a European based OEM as well. And it's also developing the technology for higher power multi-kilowatt applications. So that's also consistent with our new strategy, if you like.
As you say, your 5th development agreement in 1 or 2 years, is it?
2 years.
How significant is this for the company?
Well, over the past few years, we've developed the strategy of the company. So originally the company had a single market, single product focus. And what we've done is we've diversified the company into 4 key markets based on 2 technology platforms. So the 4 key markets that we're going after now is the home, the business, power for data centers, and also mobility and power for EVs. And we've had 4 key partners, and all of these partners are typically Fortune 500 kind of companies in each of those sectors. So this 5th partner is now starting to add on and getting multiple partners in each of these sectors. And with the 2 platforms that we've developed, we've diversified. We've always had a 1 kilowatt platform for the home, and now we're going into multi-kilowatt, so higher power, and that's really opened up these other applications of data centers, businesses, and electric vehicles.
So strategy-wise, you're on track then.
Yes,
it's very clear for you as far as the next 12, 18 months is concerned. But in terms of geographies, where are you targeting?
Well, historically, we started really, if you look at our named partners, we have Honda and Nissan in Japan, and we have Cummins in the US, and we have one other unnamed partner. So we're very strong in Asia. The US market was great, and we also had the big endorsement of the US Department of Energy. This is our first significant partner based in Europe. Where are we going next? By nature, all of these companies are global. So the big markets for this technology predominantly lie outside of the UK today, but that's where the big developers are. And in the future, we can expect more partners in the same areas, really.
And the figures are all looking so healthy. You more than doubled your revenues last year.
Yeah.
So in terms of short-term health for the company, for CeresPower, really good.
Yeah.
What does it mean for the long-term outlook?
Well, I think every one of these partners that we bring on board enables us to do 2 things. It enables us to continue to grow near-term revenue, and that contributes straight towards the growth and the funding of the company. But it really opens up new market opportunities with new applications. So that's, if you like, it adds value to the company. The other thing is, if you look at our business model, we leverage these partnerships, so it allows us to scale the business. So if you think, you know, we're comparatively a small but rapidly growing technology company, but it's the company we keep, it's the quality of these partners that we get on board that really enables us to take this technology and take it to market. And that's why each of these partners is very significant.
Let's talk about scalability. We were chatting earlier on about how it's almost the end of the combustion engine, and
yeah,
this kind of technology, fuel cell technology, is the new kid on the block. If the demand is going to rise and keep rising, how well equipped is CeresPower to meet that demand and indeed scale up when that happens?
Well, that's a good question. That's really why we have the strategy that we do. So we have a vision in CeresPower of fuel cells in every home and every business. That's only possible if you are working with the leaders in their sectors. And you can see from the types of names that we have in the public domain that we are executing against that strategy. In terms of near term, we are actually going to make some investments this year in additional capacity for the fuel cell technology. But in terms of the go-to-market approach, it's really through this strategy with the global partners. That's how we are looking to scale the business.
Tell us about your forward planning then for 2018, 2019. What should investors be keeping an eye on?
Well, we've hit this major milestone of the first 5, and I think that was really to demonstrate that it wasn't a fluke, number one, number two. This is now a continuous trend. As you mentioned earlier, we are at an age where people are starting to talk about the end of the era of combustion engines. So technologies like fuel cells are very hot right now. So we're getting more and more interest in this technology all the time, and from some global players. So beyond the five, we've already engaged with technology assessments we announced once before Christmas, which again could lead to significant partnerships in the year ahead. We are going to continue to grow, so you should expect to see growth in top line continue. We are going to invest more in the company in terms of our engineering capability, because when you're working with these large corporates, we have to be of a scale where we can actually deliver to them. Delivery is absolutely key, and we will actually make some investment in our near-term capacity. Ultimately, we expect that our operations will go, in terms of the manufacturing, will be localized to where the demand is.
Phil Caldwell, good to talk to you. Do come back and tell us more when you have more news. Thank you.
Thank you.